mock tests. They are one of the most important things for your bank exam preparation. And recently, I did a poll on my Telegram channel and I asked you your scores in your mock test. Now, I know that a lot of you have said that you are getting low scores, but there is no need to worry. In this video, I will tell you whether your mock test scores really matter and how you can increase your mock test score and how you can perfectly analyze all the mock tests that you are giving. And of course, I will also be telling you all the three important ways by which you can actually go forward with your mock test preparation. Make sure that you let me know in the comments which is the method that you prefer, and let us begin with this video.
Hi, this is Supriyo. So today we are going to take a deep dive into the mock test analysis. So how can we make it better and what's the best method to analyze the mock test? So first of all, let me tell you that we are actually going to take a look at the tips and tricks that will help you for your prelims mock test. So most of the things they are going to cover for your prelims mock test, but some of the fundamental things that I will be talking about and some of the systems you can also apply in your mains mock test. So having said that, let us find out that does your mock test score really matter? So this is a very important question, and a lot of people ask me. They say that we are getting so very low scores and we are not able to get high scores, and everybody is scoring so much more higher. Now understand something, that when you are taking a mock test, you are sitting down in a perfect environment, you are taking it seriously. But the other people who are actually attempting these questions, they might not be taking it seriously. So don't dwell too much on your exact marks. Remember this, your absolute marks don't matter. What matters is your relative marks. So you have to check whether your marks are improving as you give more mocks. That is more important than looking at what the topper has scored or what the other people have done. So your percentiles, they are not that much important. But you have to understand that each mock, you should be improving with each mock. And also, if you want to dwell too much on your score, then only take into account the live test. So sometimes there will be live tests by which they will be having some all India tests and everybody will be sitting at the same time to give that test. Only those tests you can take a little bit seriously. But the mock test, you don't know that if somebody has actually given that properly or if the topper has cheated and actually got those scores. So don't worry too much about it, and just always remember that your score should be improving and you should be learning new and new things as you give more and more mock tests. And now let us take a look into the three methods to attempt the mock tests. Now I have actually practiced all of these three methods, and I have seen that the first two methods are the ones that I actually feel comfortable with, but it will ultimately depend on you. So take a look at these different methods, and whichever is best suited to your style, go and use that. So the first method is the batching method. So in the batching method, what you do, you have certain dates in which you are going to give all the mock tests in a particular week. So you might say that, okay, I have maybe 2 days or maybe 1 day. You can maybe take out Sunday and you are giving all the mock tests on that same Sunday. You are not analyzing any mock tests, but you are just giving all of the mock tests. So you are attempting all the mocks on the same day. So this is a batching method of mock tests, and some people in the initial stages, they actually find it very useful because they can give a lot of mock tests, and the people who are working, so working candidates, this is their best bet, and they have to do the batching method. And that is why even I have also used the batching method quite a lot, and I feel that if you are doing it correctly, then it won't matter that much. So the analysis of the mock test you are doing throughout the week, but the actual attempting of the mocks you are giving on a single day for all the mocks. And then you have the alternate method. So for the alternate method, what you have to do, you are giving it on alternate days. So for example, you are giving a mock test today, you are analyzing most of the things, and maybe tomorrow also you are analyzing, you are reading some new things, and then day after tomorrow you are giving the next mock. So you are giving 1 day gap between two mocks. So that is how the alternate method actually helps. And as you become a little bit more conversant with your preparation, you can use the alternate methods, because the alternate method can help you to get a lot more mocks done. So you can actually complete a lot more mock tests by using the alternate method. And the third method is the continuous method. Now I will not suggest to do this method. Only do this if you are extremely comfortable, if you you feel that most of the things are covered. So continuous method means that each and every day you are giving at least one mock test. So mock test you are giving, analyzing, tomorrow another you are giving, then day after tomorrow you are giving another one, and so on and so forth. So you will be needing a lot of mock tests as well, but this method actually does help some people. So if you are somebody who loves to give this mock tests and you are very well prepared, then the continuous method might be able to help you. But most people, you are going to be benefited by these two methods. So ensure that whatever is natural to you, you are doing it like that. And then you have to remember that the exam environment you are creating in your house when you are actually giving the mock test. So always remember, you are sitting in front of your computer, you are not distracted at that point of time, there is no noise, you do not have any kind of people just talking to you or telling you to do some other activities, you are fully focused for that 1 hour or however long it is going to take, and you are giving those mock tests. So ensure it is as much an exam as the real exam. The same thing you have to simulate in your house. So this will be a perfect simulation of your final examination. And you also have to remember how you are going to leave the question. So leaving, this is also something very important. Many people feel that we have to find out which are the ones that we can do easily, but the trick is to know which questions you have to leave. So I keep talking about this in my various other videos. I keep talking about choosing, and this is especially important for your mains mock test. You have to choose the right questions that you want to solve, and you cannot choose without leaving some other questions. So become very good at leaving questions. Try to find out when you read a question, then always think, am I going to be able to finish this question or should I leave this question? So that is the most important skill in the mock test, and if you perfect it, then I am sure that your mock scores are going to go up very, very high. And the non-stop mocks are useless. So this is also something that I keep talking about and people are not listening to me. Non-stop mock test is never a good thing, because when you are giving a mock test, you are not learning anything new. Understand this concept very, very well. Whenever you are giving a mock test, you are applying your knowledge. You are not learning new things. And because you are constantly giving mock tests, constantly you are applying things, then when is the time for you to learn these things? So always focus that you have to have time that you put for learning the new concepts. And that is only possible when you are not giving mock tests, when you are reading from a book, or when you are doing some problems online, whatever it is. But remember this, that non-stop mock tests, it is never good for you. So just like non-stop eating, it's going to make you fat. So that's the same thing that's going to happen if you give non-stop mock tests. Now, the things that you need to do after taking a mock test. Now, this is very, very important. Before we talk about it, if you are looking for high quality mock tests, then you can check out GuideLease Express video course. In one course, you are going to get lifetime access to all the different mock tests, the live classes, the study notes, and all the important things you need to get success in all competitive examinations. You're also going to get a 100% refund if you get selected in any examination. You can get a 10% discount on their course by using the coupon code SUPRIO. So go check it out, and I am sure that this mock test is going to help you. Now, coming to the things that you need to do after taking a mock test. So the first important thing is that you have to note down your scores. So how exactly should you be noting down your scores? So create an Excel in this manner, or if you don't want to create an Excel, you can also do this thing on your normal notebook. But just write down which company's mock test you are giving first, and then write down your scores in individual subjects. So in English, in Quant, in Reasoning, just try and write down your scores, and also write down the percentiles. This is just to make you understand that you are growing or you are at the same level. That is all. The absolute value of the percentile is immaterial, and you are writing the total scores as well, and you are understanding how you are actually improving or your scores are going down. So try and mark your scores if they are too low, and if you are getting a good score, then also mark it, and it will be some positive incentive for you. So in this way, if you are creating your Excel sheet, I am sure that your marks over the long term are going to increase. So that's that. And now also, as I told you, that you don't obsess over your percentiles and your ranks. So always remember that those percentiles, those ranks, you do not know if they are authentic. So don't worry too much about those numbers. Just try to improve yourself daily. And those are not your obsessions. Your obsession should be with your own score. How are you improving, or are you falling down? So your individual score should be improving on each mock that you are giving. That is the most important thing that you have to focus. So don't focus on other people, focus on yourself. And you also have to follow the 3T method. So this method I have already talked about. So 3Ts, the first T, it stands for time. So always when you are trying to analyze the mock test, find out what is the type of question that you got right or you got wrong. So the first thing that you need to understand is that there are always types of questions. There is not something that they will be throwing you just like that. So you always have to identify which is the type, and if you are weak in that or if you are strong in that. And after that is done, you can easily note it down and you can improve by using books or using some YouTube videos or other things. And then you have to focus on the second T, which is time. So time to solve each and every problem. You should be able to understand what is your time that you are taking for solving each type of question. Can you actually reduce the time that is being taken? Always try to find out new methods. Always try to find out whether there is a way by which you can actually reduce the time that is being taken to solve these questions. So always be on the lookout for elegant solutions that I have talked about a lot of times. Elegant solutions are the key. And the third thing is the tricks. And this elegant solution is all about the tricks. Can you solve one problem in multiple ways? Try and look through the solutions. See what are they doing differently? What are you doing? What is your approach? This is the most important thing to understand. What is your thinking when you are actually solving this paper? Are you thinking in the right manner, or is the solution telling you a way by which you can think better? Always focus on making your thinking very, very clear. The person who has the clearest thinking ability is going to get the maximum amount of scores. So that is all about the 3T method. And then you have to begin with your weakest subject. So when you are doing the mock test analysis, you gave your mock test and it's over. Now, whenever you are analyzing this, this may be on the same day or it may be on some other day. This does not really matter. It is advisable if you do it a little early. So when you have given the mock, so for example, if you give it on Sunday, then at least by Tuesday, Wednesday, try and wrap up your analysis. And also remember something, that if you are giving a mock for say 1 hour, then your analysis time, it can take 2 hours. Don't worry about that at all. It can even go up to 3 hours. So sometimes the analysis time can be increased, and don't be in a hurry. You can spend a lot of time in analysis of the mocks. And many people, they feel that if I have given a 1 hour mock, then my analysis should be over in 45 minutes to an hour. No, that is not really true. I have sometimes analyzed my mocks for 3 hours, sometimes even for 4 hours, because I wanted to understand, what was I thinking? Was I thinking in the right manner? Can I attack this problem in a different way? Where is the most important clause of the puzzle? Can I find it out in this reading comprehension? Can I find an easier way by which I can solve it in this quant problem? Can I devise some kind of a new method of solving this? So always try to be on the lookout of all of these things, and these will not come if you are rushing yourself. So take time and solve these mock tests with adequate amount of time. So this is why you should be starting off with your weakest subject. So if you are very weak in reasoning, say, then when you are analyzing the mock test, start with reasoning, because you will need a lot more time to actually find out the answers. And that is why that's the first subject that you should be starting off with. Don't start it off by the default subjects. So do it like that. And the first thing that you have to do, you have to check your wrong questions. So how do we get a question wrong? So it can be either of the two things. So first thing is that you have actually solved this question in a wrong manner. So you knew the answer, you knew how to solve, but it was in a wrong way that you had done. And the second one is that you did not even know how to start this question, or it was somehow that you did not have enough time, so you did not start that question. So if you have some questions that you can solve but you did not solve, take that time and solve it yourself first. Remember this very, very important thing, that when you are solving that wrong question that you have not attempted, and you can do it if you get enough time, go for it. Just first solve it, see how long it takes you. After you have done it, just check, Did you do it in the right manner, or there was an easier way by which you could solve that question? If you can find the easy way, then it will be very, very good for you. So the wrong questions, you have to understand, you have to try and solve them yourself first. Don't immediately jump to the solutions. First try to solve it yourself first, and then if you are having problems, then see the solutions. And after that, the questions that you actually got wrong, that you knew how to do, just see where was your mistake. Was your thinking process right? Always focus on your thinking process. The way that you are actually attacking that problem, was that the correct way? Or the solution tells you a better way by which you could actually solve this problem. So always do this, and your brain should have the optimum way by which you can get to the answer. There are many, many ways by which you can solve a question, but there is only one method, that is the fastest method. So your main goal is to find out that fastest method. That's the thing that you are trying for. And that is how you are going to find the solutions for the wrong questions. And this will be the most time taking part of any mock test. You will be trying to find out the solutions for all those wrong questions that you actually could not have solved in during the test. And then you have to actually find out the correct one. So this is also a question that I got often, that should I be checking the ones that I have actually correctly attempted? The answer is yes. You should always try and see the correct solutions as well, because there might be some methods that the solution says which is much faster than what you did. So if you found that you have solved a question, say in 200 seconds, and there was a solution which could have actually allowed you to solve this in 120 seconds, then why will you not take that easy way? So that is why the correct questions you also need to see. You need to understand what's the time, the minimum time by which you can solve these questions. Test after test, you should be improving. You should not be in a stagnating kind of a position. And there is also a problem here. What happens is that the type that I told you, right? The 3T method, the first T, type. So every type of problem, when you solve them, when you understand those types, you will see that you have reached a level by which you cannot really improve that much. So that is what I call plateauing. So every question type, you are going to reach a plateau, after which it is going to be very difficult to increase your speed. So your main goal is to reach that plateau for each and every type of question that you encounter. And that is why you need to maintain an error log. This is very, very important. Maintain an error log and write down the types of questions that are actually getting missed by you in that error log, and try and find out ways by which you can solve those problems. And at the end of your preparation, that error log, you need to actually see that where are my natural weaknesses, what should I remember. And that error log is something that in the last 3 days before the examination, you need to study carefully. You need to see that you do not make the same mistakes that you have done in your mocks. And that brings us to our final goal. So final goal, what is it? It is the mock test autopilot. Now remember something, that many people say that I fear mock tests, I am not able to answer these questions, and I'm getting low scores. I have often found that this happens when people are in a panic. So you are trying too hard. You are going through the questions too fast. Now this may seem counterintuitive, but you have to slow down. Slow down. Just try and read carefully. No need to go ahead and rush through the questions. You don't need to focus on speed at that point of time. Focus on your accuracy. Remember, the person who has the most calm mind will get the most scores. This test is not about how fast you can do. It is about how much clarity of thought you can bring to the table. And this is your mock test autopilot. So when you reach the mock test autopilot mode at the end of your preparation, this means that whenever you enter into a mock test, you will immediately see that these questions are what I can do, these questions I cannot do. So I'll be leaving these, I will be doing these, and you can go just one by one without any kind of panic. So it will almost be like a flow. You will be like water. You will be adapting to every circumstance that is thrown at you. And that is the mock test autopilot. So you take the question, you solve it, you go to the next question. Yes, I can solve. Then you go ahead and solve. No, then you leave it. And like this you are going. And always remember that when you are doing the mock test, I have already shown you the three passes method. So use that three passes method. And in this manner, you can build up your calmness. You can build up that serenity that will help you to actually solve these questions in the perfect manner. And if you can reach that autopilot, I am sure that you are going to crack these examinations. My best wishes are with you. Now we are not very far away from the examination, so I wanted to give you this overview. I hope that you learned something from this video and that it was beneficial to you. If you enjoyed this session, please leave a like and share it with your friends. And if you want to see more of this type of content, please click on the subscribe button and do not forget to click the bell icon so that you, my friend, do not miss any future update. I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.